ovary wall convert into that fruit wall. So that is known as that pericarp. Okay, so what is the most important character of angiosperms? So angiosperms are food bearing plants. Fruit bearing plants. So angiosperms are fruit bearing plants, it is that objective. Okay, it means after that mature condition seeds are liberated from the fruit, but in some mangrove plants, but in some mangroves, example in rhizophora, and Avicennia, okay, seeds are germinate still attached to the fruit. Okay, in your fruit seeds are germinate present in a fruit, the fruit is still, it is attached to the stem. Attached to stem. This condition is known as a vivipari. Vivipari condition. For example, it is a plant, it is a stem. It producing of that, it is a fruit. It is a fruit. So inside the fruit, what are that? These are the seeds. These are the seeds. Seeds. So these seeds are germinate to producing plant. Okay? Still, fruit is attached to the stem. So that is known as a vivipari condition. That is known as vivipari condition. Okay? If okay, it means seeds cannot germinate, okay, before that formation of, before that falls on the soil, okay, that is known as that, okay, mangrove condition, because it is a strategy for establishment of that, okay, plantlet. It means less amount of oxygen is present in that mangrove soils, that's why for seed germination oxygen is necessary. Oxygen is necessary for every seed germination, for every seed to germination. But in mangrove plants, so less number of, less amount of oxygen is present inside the soil, seeds cannot germinate. That's why seeds germinate present in a fruit while still fruit is attached to the plant. So that is known as that, okay, so viviparous condition. After that, life cycle of angiospermic plant. So generally angiosperms are, it means they are spread from small plants to large plants. In the small plants, what is that? Wolfia. And a largest plant, is known as a eucalyptus. it grows up to that 100 meters. It grows up to that 100 meters. Okay. Generally, they are grown in tropical and subtropical regions. Generally, they are grown in tropical and subtropical regions. For example, so in the sexual reproductive organs are known as that flowers. Flowers are sexual reproductive organs. So in the flower having that, okay, so it means it contain male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ. Male reproductive organ is known as the stamen. Female reproductive organ is known as the carpel. Right? For example, you take that stamen. It is that stamen. I'm also explained before. It has mainly two parts. It is known as the filament. Above that, anther. Right? Anther producing pollen grains. Okay? So, these pollen grains are released from that anther at the time of mature condition. So in that carpel, it is divided into three parts: style, stigma, and ovary. These are the ovules. So pollen grains are falls on the stigma to form that pollen tube. Okay, by pollination method. Okay, pollen grains falls on the stigma, is known as the stigma, style, ovary, ovules. Pollen grains are falls on the stigma to germinate to that pollen tube. Then, so this pollen tube, okay, so grows in that style and reach to that ovary, to that ovule. Okay, so that is known as that, okay, fertilization process involved in that. At that time, for example, in that carpel, so it is a ovule. So in that ovule, diploid tissue is known as nucellus. In nucellus, one cell is considered as megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, producing four haploid spores. They are known as that megaspores. In out of that four megaspores, so three are degenerated, only remaining one is the functional. Okay, only one megaspore is formed. Only one megaspore is formed. So that is known as that functional megaspore. So this functional megaspore undergoes mitotic division to producing of that embryo sac. To producing of that embryo sac. Okay. It is an embryo sac. Or female gametophyte. In this mainly three parts: These are the synergids. Okay, egg operators, I am also explained before that. Egg operators. So it is known as an egg cell. So they are known as the synergids. This is another filiform operators. Right? It is known as the polar nuclei. After that, antipodal cells. At the time of fertilization, then pollen tube enter into that, okay, carrying of the male gamete. So, enter into the embryo sac. In this, two male gametes are present. Two male gametes. One male gamete fused with egg cell. Another male gamete fused with, okay, polar nuclei. So, by the, okay, syngamy, male gamete egg cell to form the zygote. By the resulting producing of the zygote, zygote is converted into that embryo. Okay? So, after second one is the triple fission. By the triple fission, it means two polar nuclei, one male gamete. So that is producing of the pen, primary endosperm nucleus. Then this primary endosperm nucleus is producing endosperm. Okay, this endosperm producing, okay, so the endosperm, okay, provide food material to the development of that embryo. Okay, so it means syngamy and triple fission both are occur in that angiosperms. It is the main important character of angiosperms. So that is known as that double fertilization. Okay, so in that some process about that life cycle of that angiospermic plant. So in the life cycle of angiospermic plant, okay,